I decided that for my boat, I want to add what's called hawseholes. I think I got that pronunciation right. This is what they would look at the back of the frigate. Unfortunately, there's not really much documentation for my particular model, but I took a look and found a few images of similar designs. And I think that this image here will be sufficient for what I need, so I'll click on it and save it. By the way, when you click on an image in a search engine, it's much better than doing things from the from the search engine itself, because when you click on the image, you get the full resolution. And this is in Bing search, anyway, that Google search does links, so it's a little different. But I select my folder here, save it, and then go inside my blend file. And just as before, just drag it in. This is the image. Scale it up to what I need. And I'll just use it for a reference. I've been thinking a little bit about the shape of what I want to create, and I think that I'll need an even number of vertices with a circle. If I take a look at my circle that I cannot see right now because it's way too far back, it should be possible to split it in two. If you look at this, this could work because this vertex here can be replaced. So what I'll do is simply rotate on the y-axis 90 degrees, rotate z 90 degrees, and then we're going to bring that out, grab y. Okay. Now I press 1 to hit the back view. At least that's how my model is placed right now. And we're going to remove these vertices, grab this, and then scale it, or actually not scale it because that would result in an oval, right? So instead, I'll just grab these on the x-axis. Here looks roughly correct. And then, it might help me to scale it to about the same thing. And I can adjust the size later. So what I want to do now is to connect these. And I'll scale it in just a little bit because I'm compensating for the size of two vertices. It's going to be slightly more ovular. And what I want to do now is figure out how I want to do my extrusions. So for this, I can tell there's a kind of border along the edge. So if I do a scale, I'll be able to imitate that border. And now, realism was too extreme for me. Now I'm going to extrude again and then scale inwards to the size of the hole. And I think I'll be able to add a loop cut here in the middle. The reason I'm adding a loop cut is that I want this to be a smooth transition. So if I go in my 3D view and find the part I'm working on, I can do control with middle mouse button to zoom in and out. So if I do grab Y, I'll be able to kind of smooth and then do Alt and then grab Y again. And this is going to be the back. So you can see the whole thing is taking shape. And since it's going to be 3D printed, it'll smooth out. So at the back here, I want this to be solid because I'm just going to paint it black. I don't want water to go in my boat at this point. And then we're going to select this. And I should be able to make a border, so I'm going to do extrude, and then on the y-axis, I'm going to scale it out a little bit, and I'm going to exaggerate the scaling of the border, because I think that the 3D print will be slightly smaller than what this looks like, so the details are less accurate, so I need to kind of exaggerate the details on this mesh here. I'll grab y a little bit further, just to make sure that it has enough space to add its extrusion layers. And then I'm going to extrude scale, so E and S, and give myself a little bit of a border here, and then extrude on the y-axis. And I'm going to go behind the other part. And then to complete the hole, I'll just do F, and that is going to create a solid, right? And I think I could scale it in just a slight bit to save on a bit of material, but at this point, I mean, it's really not going to matter much. So let's go on to the smoothing now. This is what's adding the shape that we want. So I'm going to add a modifier and do a subdivision surface. And then at this point, I would just make sure that all the sharp edges remain sharp. So I know that most of my edges are sharp, actually. So let me just do, well, no. I can't do that because it'll select the edges here. So I'm doing Alt and click, by the way, and then Shift-Alt for this one. Shift-Alt for this one. And I do Shift-E, and then drag my mouse to smooth them. At the back here, let's go into our wireframe mode and do Alt again. And then Shift-E. That's going to harden the back edge. And the real reason is that this should be smooth around here, and the rest should be solid. So it creates this shape, as you can see. Now let's have a little bit more in the viewport so that we can see properly. We'll have a beautifully smooth image. I'm going to scale this out a little, scale it in a little bit so that it's more of a round shape. And perhaps I'll drag it out a bit more to add to that impression of depth. And there you go. There's our Hawsehole, as far as I can tell. Now I might want to bring this back a little bit, just so that it's deeper and it looks darker when you look at it. I will paint the back black if I can, but I do think there's space here to grab on the y-axis and bring it out. Oh, and over here I can see, I'd like, when I install this, I'm going to pierce a hole in the wood, so I'd like for the edge to be flat. So I'm going to drill an oval. Let's go on edge selection mode, and select this, and then do Shift E again. Solid. Right, and then all I need to do is evaluate the size of my shape. So let's go and drag it in here. And from what I can tell right now, it's very large compared to what I need it. So I'm going to select all with A, and then scale down. Now one thing I want to do is bring the vertex. So I'm going to bring the origin, origin to center of mass. I'm going to scale it down to an appropriate size. I'm going to cross compare, and of course my ship is shaped a little differently from this one, but I'm going to go for roughly this size, I would say. Now I'm realizing that I could remove some sharpness on this edge here, depending on the model I want to do. But of course, since it's going to be 3D printed, the layers will kind of hide the details that are being used here. So I won't be too picky about that. The edge here could be a little smoother as well. Okay. Now I'm also seeing that this seems to have somewhat gotten scaled inwards. So I'm going to grab on the x-axis. Bring this back to a size that I think is more equal on both sides. It's 2. Right. And there we go. Now I'm going to transfer it to Cura. So let's get ready to do that. Here what we need to do is go in File and Export STL. Here you want to make sure you select Selection Only. And then we're going to do Hawsehole and export the STL file. You want it to be the same scale, 1.0. Perfect. And now we're waiting for Cura to turn on. Let me just see what's happening. It's loading, which is perfect. Let me just go to my folder where I exported this. I can't say I remember where I exported it, so go check. OneDrive ship models. Alright, perfect. So we have here the Hawsehole. Just need to take it and drag it into Cura. This is obviously way too large, so we need to scale it down to about 1/10. There we go. And I'm going to rotate it because I think that it could be printed without any support whatsoever at this angle here. I'm just going to make sure to say, don't generate any supports. That's looking quite good to me. So all I'll do now is do a multiply. for this, I have decided to do at least four in the back and maybe a few more elsewhere, but I'll start with four and see if that size suits me. So let's go to the, let's see, I think there's a multiply selected model, copies four. Okay, there we go. Now we have multiplied it in Cura. I have a finer setting, I'll choose ultra fine, keep my previous settings, and slice this. And there we go. We can see that here, it's kind of like spaghetti noodles are each one of the extrusions. And this is looking quite good to me. However, you can see also that we've lost a lot of the shape that was there, the kind of angled curved shape, because the printer is relatively inaccurate. This is what I mean when you say exaggerate the shape that you want to make. So what I'll do is go back in here and select these two and scale them in so that we see more of that shape going on. I'll grab this one and I think I can move it outwards quite a bit. Maybe even what we can do is this, Control B for bevel, and add a couple of bevel loops here, grab Y, and that will have a more, maybe, emphasized shape. Let's do the same thing, export the STL, Hawsehole Perfect, I'm going to crash the copy, and go here. Let's delete this, and then drag this back in, and we repeat the same process again. So let's scale it back to 1000, and then rotate 90 degrees. Let's see if this has a better slice. Okay. I can see the shape there. I think it's working out. It could be emphasized more, but for the purposes of this video, I won't belabor the point. And then we'll multiply by 4. Perfect. And then slice it for a complete view. I'll add in the thumbnail of the video what this would look like, and it should give you a good idea of what I'm making.